What's up out there, you guys? Marty Schwartz here with GuitarJams.com. Going to teach you a real easy beginner acoustic strummer. And I just want to let you know real quick, you can sign my email list down there to get a free ebook that has all the beginner chords and the basic pentatonic scales in there. Anyway, I'm going to teach this to you right now. Hang tight. All right, so let me show you. I just took the capo off, but we're going to put a capo on the third fret and play just a handful of easy beginner chords. But the real original way that this is played is to put the guitar in drop D tuning first. And so what we do is we're going to play this D string right here. And then we want to lower our E down a whole step to be the octave of that D. Listen, just use your ear. I just matched them up. Listen to that. Now I'm going to bring it lower and bring it up to pitch. Watch. And so when you get that, if you play a whole thing there, it'll sound like a full D chord. We've got the drop D going, and then we put the capo on the third fret. And I think, you know, the real reason is because the song's using a D chord, and when you put it in drop D, you can strum the whole guitar for this D chord. So it's a nice full chord, and you know, with the capo right here and playing this shape, it actually ends up being, you know, note-wise an F major chord. But don't worry about that. So we'll just call it D. So we need that chord, and we need a G chord. And so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my pinky and put it down on the third fret of the high E. My ring finger is already there. And then because we're in drop D, we play this G chord a little differently. Index finger goes to the second fret of the A string. And that's the G chord. Now you could get that low note in there, or you can let your index finger kind of mute it. So we need that, and we need an A major chord. And with the A major chord, you could add your pinky to that third fret on the B. Or you could take your ring finger off. And you can add little extra melodies when you hit that A chord. So that's all you need. Three chords, D, G, and A. All right, so now let's pick out the progression, and I'm gonna show you the rhythm too. So the rhythm is gonna go like this. So check it out, down, down, up, down, up, 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 down, down, up, down, up. So that's one rhythm sequence. And so right off the bat, there's two parts. There's a chorus, and the song starts with a chorus, and then there's a verse. And they're almost identical. So check this out. We're gonna start with a G chord for one rhythm pattern. Down, down, up, down, up, and then a rhythm pattern on A. So we got one on G, one on A. So check it out. Then one on D, and then one on G. So here we go, check it out. So we got one on G, one on A, one on D, one on G. Here we go. Then one on D, one on G again. And then two on A. So here we go. And see where I added the pinky and ring? That's just, you know, I just improvised that a little bit. A little extra flavors there. Okay, now check this out. Here's the second half of the chorus. Starts the exact same way. So we got G, 1, A, 1, D, 1, G, 1, D for 1, G for 1, A for 1, D for 1, then another 2. Or a half. It depends on when you're going to start with your words again. But so we've got, here's the whole chorus. Goes into the verse, and the verse is almost exactly the same as the chorus, except it's an extra sequence of D and G. So you've got G for one rhythm, and then A, and then you've got three sets of D to G. So it's like, it's not an even amount of time. So watch, here's the verse. So one D to G, another D to G, and now another D to G. Then an A for two rhythms. See that? So the only difference is it's just an extra bar, is what you would call it, of D to G. That's it. And it repeats, it's going to repeat that again. G, A, D, G, D, G, again. D, G, then the A chord. See that? So here's the chorus again. I'm going to play the chorus one time all the way through, and then I'm going to play the verse one time all the way through, and I'll say the chords as we go out loud. Here we go. Here's the verse. I'm sorry. Don't mean to confuse you. Here's the chorus. One, two, one, two. Here we go. That's the lesson, you guys. Remember, you can get that free ebook by signing my email list down there. Otherwise, got some more free lessons coming your way real soon. Thanks a lot.